And now we will learn how to charge late fees to the tenants. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Very often, tenants agree to pay a specific amount in late fee if they pay rent after a specific day of the month. We are already set up to charge late fees and put them on an invoice. A late fee is only one example of how to charge a tenant for something that we earn in income. If you charge for something else that counts as income to you, then you should use this late fee video as an example of how to set it up and how to do it. Do you remember the setup items that we did together? Back at the beginning of the course, after we put in the chart of accounts, we put two items on the items list. We put the monthly rent item that we could list on an invoice, and when we list that on an invoice, the money amount for that gets recorded into this account in the chart of accounts, rental income earned. But we also put in the items list the late fee, and we set it up in such a way that if we put late fees on an invoice, the money amount of the late fee goes into that income account, income from late fees. So this is the first time we're actually putting that item on an invoice, and it makes sense that it would get tracked to a different income account. You can add the late fee to an existing invoice or make a separate invoice to charge the late fee. So example one, add $50 late fee to the June 30th invoice for Betty for past overdue invoices. Well, that's very simple. We can just open up her invoice and add it. So if we go to the tenant balance detail, we can find Betty and we'll find the June 30th invoice and double click. Now right now there's only one item on the June 30th invoice, it's the rent due. So click directly under rent due and add the other item that we've been ignoring all along, late fee. And in this case the amount she agreed to pay was $50. Notice the amount of the total of the invoice changes, and instead of owing us $1,000 for June, she now owes us $1,050 for June. Specifically, the $50 is for late fees. When we click Save and Close, we can see that Betty's balance has increased by $50, specifically because that $50 was added to this very same invoice for the late fees. Now, if we click the trial balance, you can see that income from late fees shows up for the very first time on the trial balance. And if we double click, we can see that it's specifically from invoice number 10 for Betty. And now let's try this. Let's imagine on July 15th, we made a separate invoice for Dave for a $100 late fee charge. And sometimes it does happen that you put it on a separate invoice. Well, that's very simple. If we look at Dave's balance right now, Dave owes us $7,500. He's about to owe us $7,600, but that would be dated separately because he wants that on a separate invoice. So it's no problem. Invoice, and the invoice is for Dave. Notice rent receivable is correct because Dave has a really big positive balance. And we're imagining that we're charging him this on July 15th. Is that correct? Yes, it's July 15th, and we're not putting rent on this invoice. We're making a separate invoice just for the late fees and telling him, hey, buddy, in addition to the rent that you owe, you now owe this separate $100 as a late fee. When we click Save and Close, we can see Dave's balance has increased specifically by this $100, and it became $7,600. If you look at the trial balance, you can see income from late fees has increased to $150. And when we double click, we can see that The reason that income from late fee is $150 is because we charged 50 to one and 100 to the other, and we could always double click and see who this is and what the invoice